Hi, I'm Radizio, and this is an automatic zero-tick kelp farm, and you should definitely build it in your own Minecraft world. But why? Why is kelp so useful? Well, because it's a great food source, you can turn it into furnace fuel, or as any great builder would tell you, it's an amazingly good-looking block. But most importantly of all, this kelp farm is the best way to get infinite amounts of XP. Now what we're gonna need isn't all that much, as you can see right here. And if you're new here, a sub to the channel would be amazing. Alright, let's go. Now, it's very important that you chunk align this farm, otherwise it might break in the future. And if you don't know what that is, that's okay. It's very simple and I explain it to you in this video. The link will also be in the description. Okay, so to begin, we're gonna place down 5 simple blocks, and these can be any kind of blocks that you want. And then simply just place 5 pistons on top of those 5 blocks, just like that. And then put another row of blocks in front like this. And then just simply line the top of those blocks with a layer of sand. There you go, that is the first part all done. Now we're gonna place down a kind of V-shaped thing in front here like that, and then put a redstone torch on this block right there with a lever on top. Now put your redstone repeater in here just like that, and the piston here should extend. That is perfectly fine. Now put a piece of redstone dust right there, and you see that we now have created a clock. Now this is going to come in really handy. So now we're gonna place down 5 more blocks just like this. And then simply line the top again with redstone this time. And then here, we're just gonna connect these 2 redstone lines, and now all the pistons should extend at the same time. All right, now let's go ahead and place our other 10 pieces of sand. And the way we're gonna do that is simply by placing them on top of these pistons right here. And we want this kind of wall to be 2 blocks tall. There we go. Now, before we do anything else, we're gonna just barricade in this sand so that it can definitely not fly anywhere. There we go. We're gonna do the same thing on this side right here. Keep on doing that, like that. Now we're gonna extend this wall just by 1 more block in the back here. Now put down a single line of just normal pistons on top of those blocks. Now 1 more line on top of these pistons. There we go. Just like that. Now take out your stairs, and we're gonna place them down just like this so that they are facing upside down, and this will be for waterlogging them later. Now go ahead and take another row of blocks and place them just like this in front of those stairs. Right, so that is looking very good already. Now we're just gonna simply build a kind of wall right here to barricade in the farm. There we go. Just a few more blocks like that. And then come around to the back, and over here you want to make another layer of blocks right beneath the pistons. So there you go. Alright, now for a little bit more redstone. Go ahead and take another redstone torch and put it on the top of this block right there. And take your planks or any other block and put it like that with another torch on top. Put another block, and we have now simply just made this redstone signal go up, and we're gonna line the top of these blocks with another layer of redstone. There you go. Now you can see that all of these pistons have also extended. That is really good. That is exactly what we want. Now we're gonna do the same thing by placing down a kind of wall here on the side. Very nice, looking good. Now go ahead and grab out your panes, because we're gonna be needing those next, as well as your water and your kelp. There we go. Now, before we place down the water, we're gonna make sure that we have a kind of barricade for that water. So we're gonna just use some panes here, and that is going to allow us to harvest the kelp later on. So now you can see that the pistons are all extended. Now, when we're gonna place down the water, that is going to be a little bit messy. So that's why we're gonna deactivate those pistons just for a little while we place the water. Now, in survival, you would then make a kind of water source, but I'm in creative, so that's why I'm just gonna waterlog all of these stairs. Remember, this was a line of stairs right there. All right, now we can place down 5 pieces of kelp. So yes, you're gonna need some kelp to get this farm started. There you go. And now we can just simply replace this piece of redstone, and this should then extend those pistons. Now you'll also see that the kelp has turned those water blocks into some source blocks, and that is perfectly normal. That is what we want. Now just head down and flick this lever, and you'll see that the kelp will start pouring down on top of you. Now dudes, I do have to give some credit to Navy Nexus for inventing this kind of zero ticking, and if you're looking to convert this kelp farm into an unlimited XP farm, you can click right here, and I will catch you guys over there.